Good morning, everyone. You know, I did shower this morning. I don't know why these pews are open, but okay, I'll walk to you. So our service for this morning is going to begin in your blue hymn books. You're going to need a hymn book because this is not going to be up on the screen. So if you take your blue hymn book and open to page 10, there's a brief order for confession and forgiveness that you'll find there. Page 10, and you'll notice there's two separate columns. We're going to be in the right-hand side as soon as I do the opening blessing. So page number 10, right-hand side. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the aid of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that, attentive to your word, we may confess our sins, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Now we're on page 11, right-hand column. Gracious God, have mercy on us. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Please stand as you are able for the opening hymn. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Ever-loving God, your Son gives himself as living bread for the life of the world. Fill us with such a knowledge of his presence that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life to serve you at all times. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The congregation may be seated for the reading of Scripture.
Our first lesson comes from Proverbs chapter 9. Wisdom has built her house. She has hewn her seven pillars. She has slaughtered her animals. She has mixed her wine. She has also set her table. She has sent out her servant girls, she calls from the highest places in the town. You that are simple, turn in here. To those without sense, she says, come eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed. Lay aside immaturity and live, and walk in the way of insight. Our second lesson comes from Ephesians chapter 5. Be careful then how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise, making the most of the time because the days are evil. So do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit. As you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Here ends the readings. Please rise for the gospel. Thank you.
Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 6th chapter. I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, that person will live forever. And the bread which I shall give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. But the one who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise that person up at the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in you. As the living Father sent me, I live because of the Father. So the one who eats me will live because of me. This is the bread which came down from heaven, not such as the fathers ate and died. Whoever eats this bread will live forever." The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. I'd like to talk a little biology today. You know, before God tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Walk this way," I was headed in the direction of becoming a veterinary doctor. I always loved biology, and I was pretty good at it. But once chemistry entered the curriculum, well, that's when God said, "Psst, no, over here, walk this way." Ever since, I have always found ways to include science and religion as part of my faith. They go hand in hand. They belong together. So I'd like to talk about biology today. What do you know about the digestive tract? Once you eat something, what happens? Where does it go? Well, the very first part of the digestive process is when you put food in your mouth and you start chewing. And there's saliva that helps dissolve it and break it down, and then it goes into your stomach. And with the help of some digestive enzymes, after it leaves your stomach, it goes into your intestines. It's in your intestines, then, where your body can extract all the good vitamins and nutrients from the food that you have eaten and then sends the rest out to exit your body. Now, all those great vitamins and nutrients that you have just eaten, because you had a big salad, right, then break down and go into every one of your cells, your brain, your bones, your hair, your skin. They support your energy levels and, in fact, your very entire being. Eating is crucial to our lives. And as the saying goes, you are what you eat. So now let's talk about that gospel reading I just shared with you. Today's gospel has been cleaned up quite a bit since being translated from the Greek into English. In Greek, it is truly offensive and, dare I say, hard to swallow. When Jesus talks about eating his flesh, in the Greek, he used words like chew my flesh, gnaw on my bones. I actually found it difficult to read in English. Eat my flesh? Ugh! And this passage is exactly why early Christians were accused of being cannibals. Blah. Now, when I have taught First Communion classes over the years, I have heard countless stories from adults as they shared their experiences of First Communion. And they were all warned to work up some saliva in their mouth when they came forward for communion, so when the wafer was put in your mouth, you could simply swallow it whole, because chewing was not allowed. But that's not what Jesus wants us to do. Jesus wants us to eat him up, chew him up, swallow him down, so that his very body will be digested by our bodies, so that he can become a part of our body, so that he can become the vitamins and the nutrients that our very souls need. We can only do that if we eat his flesh and drink his blood, so that he will become part of us, literally, on a cellular level. He infiltrates every cell of our being. His body builds us up and keeps us alive. Jesus becomes a staple for our daily lives. And this is why some Christians, some churches, believe that communion should be served at least every Sunday, if not at every Bible study, council meeting, or any time people gather together at church. We need to take Jesus in. Jesus, the human, was God incarnate, that is, God in the flesh. And then he offered his in the flesh for us in the meal of Holy Communion. He wanted to be in our flesh, incarnate in us. And then with Christ as a very part of our bodies, our cells, our souls, we can go out in the flesh and offer our bodies for others by the way we serve, by helping someone out financially or some group financially, by making a meal for the grieving, by listening quietly as someone shares their struggles with us, by celebrating with those who have overcome a great challenge, by joining Bible study together, by teaching Sunday school, by sewing quilts and putting together layettes, school and health kits, by offering a smile to the cashier, by standing firm and Christ-like in the face of violence, gossip, and trash talking. Our bodies need food. They need sustenance in order to accomplish all those things I just mentioned. We must eat of the bread of heaven, Jesus Christ our Lord. There is no other way to survive and thrive. Jesus feeds us. We take him in, and he becomes our body. Remember? You are what you eat. And then we feed others. Remember his words. Take and eat. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Now feed my sheep. Amen. Stand as you are able, as together we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Wisdom has built her house. May the church be a house of wisdom for all who enter. May we continue to grow and stretch in ways we never thought possible. Merciful God, wisdom has mixed her wine. May the harvest seasons be plentiful this year. We pray for orchards, vineyards, farms, and all of creation. Protect and conserve the earth. Merciful God, wisdom has employed her laborers. Be with all who seek adequate employment. Guide our economic and governmental leaders to support the people of our world with fair wages and safe working conditions. Merciful God, wisdom has invited her guests. Make your presence known to all who feel lost, abandoned, or hurting at this time. Direct your Holy Spirit of care to all who seek healing and comfort, especially those we now name either silently or aloud. Terry, Kurt, merciful God, wisdom has set her table. May this congregation be a welcome table to all who seek the refuge of God. Break down walls and barriers that prevent us from offering a seat at this table to anyone who comes. Merciful God, wisdom has shown her path of insight. May we journey on her paths, looking toward a bright future while remembering where we have come. We give our thanks for those who have gone before us. Merciful God, into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us turn to one another and share a sign of that peace and love of God. You may be seated for the announcements. Okay, so a couple announcements coming up for September. Parents of confirmands. We are having a parents meeting for confirmation on September 11th. That's a Wednesday night at 6:30 at Grace Ripon. This area of churches, Grace Ripon, Zion, St. Stephen's, and Peace in Rosendale, we're all going to join together for confirmation, and we'll have a parents meeting at Grace at 6:30 on the 11th, and classes will start the following Wednesday night. You'll be seeing more information about this in future bulletins and newsletters. Also, please remember that September 18th, St. Stephen's will be having their outdoor 9 o'clock worship, and we're doing this not as a retirement, not as a goodbye party, but as a thank you to Jen. So I'll be getting you more information on that if you would like to attend that. And next Sunday, we're gonna have a baptism here, woohoo! So another baby to join the family. Hopefully you will be here and support the family as they introduce their new baby. Are there other announcements to be shared? Very well, then, we have a video from Lutheran World Relief to share with you today.
Earthquakes and flooding, conflict and violence, hunger and extreme poverty. Where there is suffering, your love is there. Since 1945, following the Second World War, Lutheran World Relief has worked ceaselessly to end poverty, injustice, and human suffering. We provide aid in emergencies and help families restore their lives. We partner with communities to build and grow rural economies. We break the cycle of poverty so families and communities can thrive. For nearly 80 years, you have responded to God's call to be the body of Christ in the world. Because of you, we reach further, stay longer, and stand faithfully alongside our neighbors in need. Because of you, hundreds of thousands of families have been comforted by LWR quilts and kits. Because of you, the hardest to reach neighbors in Peru are leading their communities out of poverty. Because of you, a mother in Mali is rejoicing that her child has enough food to eat and grow after being at the brink of death. Because of you, a family in Ukraine has access to mobile medical clinics and can get life-saving health care despite living amid ongoing violence. Because of you, hope is being restored.
Я вдячна дуже, дуже. У мене немає просто вже.
A los pueblos más olvidados han ayudado. Muchas gracias, Anita.
Who will your love reach next?
Once again, a special thank you to all of you who have donated money to Lutheran World Relief or have donated any part of any kit that we have made here at Zion. Let us present our offerings to God. Please stand as you are able for the offertory. Let us pray. Merciful God, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, holy God, through Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection has opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And now, Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God, you are welcome at this table. The congregation may be seated, and would the assistant please come forward? Please rise as you are able for the blessing. Now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen us and keep us in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you provide the true bread from heaven, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that we who have received the sacrament of his body and blood may abide in him and he in us, that we may be filled with the power of his endless life, now and forever. Amen. And now receive the final blessing. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. You may be seated for the closing hymn. Now go in peace. You are the body of Christ now.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.